a personal thing. If you don't have a personal connection with the King of Kings, if you don't have a personal connection and revelation about God, you will struggle in worship. Have you not found yourself in a place where they sang the amazing songs, where the Spirit was available in that moment? But then all you kept doing was looking at your shoe. All you kept doing was looking at your hair. All you kept doing was focusing on someone else. Hello friends, welcome to Motivation Corner. This is your girl Hetty here. I am so excited to be bringing you today's edition. Thank you for the support, the love. I'm so grateful, okay? And don't forget to subscribe. If you've been here so many times and you still haven't subscribed, well, I don't know what you're waiting for, okay? So in today's edition, I wanted us to talk about why we worship. Why is worship a fundamental thing in our Christian life? So I wanted to bring a little bit of my understanding about why we worship. So today, my scripture will be taken from 1 Peter 2 verse 5 and then 1 Peter 2 verse 9, okay? So 1 Peter 2 verse 5 says that you also, as lively stones, are built up as a spiritual house and holy priesthood to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God by Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And the 1 Peter 2 verse 9 says, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who had called you out of the darkness into his marvelous light. The reason why we worship is because God desires us to worship him. He made us to worship him. It is his desire that we will come to him with worship. It is a way of us drawing closer to him. He desires to be with us. So it is in worship that we are drawn to him. It is in his purpose for us that we, as people he has called us out of darkness, as people he has saved, as people he has rescued, as people he has brought into the light, as people he has made as his chosen generation, that we worship him. He desires that we worship him, because in worship, where our spirit commune with his, then he becomes intimate with us. He becomes involved in whatever concerns us. He becomes involved and intimate with everything that we are. You know, our worries, our concerns, he becomes involved with everything that we are. Hallelujah. Also, when we worship God, we worship him because it is a show of our faith. It is a display of our faith towards him. It is a show that we have confidence in him for who he is. You know, when you look on the news, there are not many good news out there, but when we come into that place of worship, when we pour out our hearts to our King and our Lord, we are saying to him, we have faith in you. We have faith that you are able to do exceedingly abundantly above all. He's able to change things, and we come to him in faith, in worship, showing to all that we have faith and confidence in God. Psalm 57 verse 7, it says, my heart is steadfast, O Lord. It just means my heart is confident in you, O Lord. Worship is a display of faith in God. Hallelujah. Also, worship involves surrendering and offering a personal sacrifice to God. You see, worship is a personal thing. If you don't have a personal connection with the King of Kings, if you don't have a personal connection and revelation about God, you will struggle in worship. Have you not found yourself in a place where they sang the amazing songs, where the Spirit was available in that moment? But then all you kept doing was looking at your shoe. All you kept doing was looking at your hair. All you kept doing was focusing on someone else. It's because you lack that revelation. You lack a personal revelation with God. When you have a relationship with God, you come to him in reverence, in honor. You know who he is. So when you come into his presence, when you come in worship, you don't waste time because you know who you serve. You know who you've come to worship. So worship involves surrendering our personal offering, a personal sacrifice. You know, you come to Him abandoning all worries, all thoughts, anything that serves as a distraction, and you focus on Him. We remove the focus from us and onto Him. Hallelujah. And that brings us closer to Him, and that brings us into that intimate place with Him. I hope you've been blessed. Don't forget to leave me a comment, okay? Or let me know how you are benefiting from this. Hallelujah. I pray that God keeps you and your family, and I will see you in my next video, okay? Don't forget, share so that other people will also hear the good word of God, okay? Be blessed.